Hello, I'm Charles Fisher of FishDuck.com.
For Oregon fans and the staff at FishDuck.com, this has been an amazing football season. We lost two games, yet remain in the nation's top five teams, and for us long-term fans, an incredible third BCS game in a row. We began to closely analyze the Oregon offense this year, and we're delighted to have all the surprises from Chip that have been wonderfully entertaining. We have learned how so much of the Oregon spread is predicated upon what the defense gives us, and how we read defenders on almost every play. This Pac-12 championship game gave us numerous examples of that, and could be the epitome of a complete read game from Oregon and Darren Thomas. We examine with pride at the success of a few passing game reads in this game, and yet with regret at having the season come to an end.
My friends, this website has become pretty expensive, yet I see how the overall knowledge level of Duck fans has gone way up because of our presence. I'm asking for sponsors, a monthly fee to advertise as well as have your logos on the site, and the cost will be pretty modest for quite some time. I need to make costs each month, and I want to feature companies that can serve the attractive demographic that is checking into this site. We already have features that nobody else has, such as video analysis of the Ducks as well as the opponents, and that video highlight archive that nobody else has. It's a great start for 4 months, but we have amazing plans for this site going forward, and they can be achieved with sponsors. So if you're interested, would like to get the numbers on it, email me at charles@fishduck.com. Thanks.
Darren has several players to check on at the beginning of a play, such as the free safety, the player to be read in our zone read play, and linebackers. Note the positioning of the linebacker just inside the slot receiver, and it looks like he's leaning inside. As the ball is snapped, the linebacker does blitz, and Darren sees it, pulls the ball from the running back during the mesh, and tosses it to Josh Huff, who makes the most of it for 20 yards. It all begins with a great read by Thomas to act upon what the defense offers. In the first quarter, we're running an inside zone read and reading the defensive end. We are serious about threatening the bubble pass with triple wide receivers or trips left. Our trailing receiver has the Bruin safety's attention as he moves to cut off our bubble pass. Look at how Weems, the yellow arrow, has sealed his defender to the outside nicely, while the defensive tackle of UCLA, the blue arrow, is driving York hard inside, as are all the defenders trying to fill the gaps on this fourth down and short play. He's gone! From behind, we see the defensive end being zone red, the light blue circle, the great block of Weems, the yellow arrow, the UCLA defensive tackle intent on just driving York backwards, which is the red arrow, and good technique shown by the Bruin defensive tackle driving and watching the play, which is the blue arrow. The UCLA defensive tackle keeps driving York backward while LaMichael just zips by. That's poor technique, and it costs the Bruins an easy touchdown. Look who the defensive tackle was under the red arrow with the poor technique. It was whom we call Ola, a former five-star defensive end from Portland who declined coming to Oregon and went to UCLA.
Coach Mike, you were super in reviewing many plays with me like this one, and I'm very grateful. Thanks.
When Oregon is clicking in its no-huddle offense and we have a fourth down and short, it's common for us to run another play quickly right into the line like this power play for a first down, and opponents know it. Look at this third down and how we run an inside zone read with trips to the left, and UCLA matches up 3-on-3 with them. Look at the result of the next play when we snap the ball within 9 seconds after that third down play when we go for it on fourth and short. Go back and see how the Bruins were so focused upon stopping the quick inside play that they neglected to get outside to cover the trips left again. Note the safety knows he should be over there, but is looking into the backfield, the blue arrow, for the handoff. It's a great example of the no-huddle, hurry-up offense messing opponents up, but also the read by Darren to immediately see the favorable matchup and get the ball out there ASAP. As the game continued, we capitalized upon our superb blocking between the tackles, and UCLA became very focused upon stopping the inside zone read. Oregon is driving and threatening with our backfield formation to run another inside zone read, thus we see 8 UCLA defenders in the box or close to the line of scrimmage. That leaves two corners and a free safety for UCLA to play a three-deep zone defense to counter the three wideouts Oregon has lined up. Darren is about to have the ball snapped when he gets a new signal from the sidelines for a different play. Why? As the quarterback is doing the mesh with the running back, we see the UCLA linebacker step up and lean forward and begin run support of the upcoming inside zone. As he's doing that, we see David Paulson taking off on a pass pattern straight up the field. Thomas is checking the linebacker as he does the mesh. If the linebacker moves to cover a tight end, then the quarterback next checks the defender to be read that play, the defensive end, to determine if he hands off to the running back or keeps. If the linebacker is being beaten downfield, as he was, then Darren throws to the tight end, David Paulson. Now I know the play called in. Once Chip saw the 3D coverage, he sent in the play that sends four receivers vertically down the field, hence someone won't be covered. It's a tremendous example of how our coach took what the defense gave him, while our quarterback made several reads on one play to decide how to capitalize on Bruins' weakness. Even with all the analysis up in the booth and the decisions on the field, you still have to execute with all the blocks made, good routes run, and a pass delivered accurately. That is true teamwork for a touchdown, my friends.
My thanks to Coach Dan for his tips on this play and others on defense that we'll see in future videos. You cannot imagine the fun it is having a chalk talk with these coaches and learning great stuff that we all benefit from. Thanks to all you coaches for your help with me this season. If you sign up for the Fish Letter, I will not sell your name to anyone. Folks who have been on my email list for years can confirm that. I just don't want anyone to miss any videos coming out, as Josh and I will still be doing two or three a month, just not on a schedule. Josh will do a Wisconsin analysis before the Rose Bowl, and then he'll begin analyzing the Ducks as I do. Go to the top and see the tab that you can click on and sign up for the Fish Letter, and you'll be notified whenever a new video comes out, since it won't be every week. I put an average of 20 hours a week into each video, in addition to other duties on the site, and then I have my full-time regular job as well, so I might need a little break of a week or so here. However, we will have new videos coming out shortly, so sign up now and be assured of privacy and safety from me. We knew this season would be a ton of work and great fun, and it has been. What we did not expect is how when you learn something new and appreciate the player strategy and then see it again executed flawlessly, it almost brings a tear to your eye. We're not just enjoying Oregon games more. We are savoring those sips of football wine and finding that we're thrilled with individual plays because we better understand what's happening on the field. Thank you for sharing the journey and learning right along with me. Oh, how we love to learn about our beloved Ducks. I'm Charles Fisher, Fish Duck, and for more videos and reports, come to fishduck.com.